Amen. Amen. Why is the king so angry? Bible says that, amen, that his face begins to change and his visage, amen, his face, he gets so angry and red, amen, that his face begins to change. Amen. Because, amen, amen, that these three Hebrew boys are not bowing to the image. Amen. Amen. Now, this might just be me, amen, but I'm persuaded to believe, amen. Amen. I'm persuaded to believe, amen, that one of the reasons why the king is so mad, amen, is because, you remember in the chapter 1, amen, he chooses more than the three, than the four. Amen. I'm persuaded to believe, amen, that there were Jews bowing. Amen. And he's so mad now because there are three still standing. Amen. I'm persuaded. Why else would he get so angry? Amen. This might just be me, amen, but I'm persuaded to believe, amen, that these three were standing, amen, while the other ones had fell down and begin to worship, the graven image. It's here, amen, that I want to say, amen, that they are selected by God. Amen. If you remember, amen, these are the most esteemed of them. Amen. They were, all of them were smart, but there was something special about Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Amen. There was something special about them. Amen. Amen. That they had this tenacity. Amen. That said, amen, that we will not move off the standard and of the things of the statutes that God has said. Amen. Amen. There's a blessing now in the separation. There's a blessing now, amen, that they understand to be separate from God. I mean, to be separate from the world means to be separate unto God. Amen. The scriptures, the New Testament tells us, amen, over and over again. The scriptures tell us, amen, amen, that to be us, to be free from sin is to be a slave unto righteousness. Amen. To be free from the world is to be a servant from Christ. Amen. Somebody you have to serve. Amen. Somebody you have to, amen, lend your members over to. Right. Amen. But it's here, amen, that I want to bring unto our focus, amen, that these three do not budge. Bible says that they stand before God. Amen. They stand on the statutes. They stand on the principles. They stand on what they know. They stand on what they were being taught. Amen. And God blesses them. Amen. Amen. Now, I want to bring this out. Amen. It's not the fact that we struggle with holiness all of the time. Most of the time, amen, we struggle with being righteous. Amen. We struggle, amen, amen, with our heart not being right. Amen. The reason why the young lady keeps sleeping around, amen, it's because there's a problem deep down in the heart. Amen. Amen. Because we can change the action. I can tell her stop sleeping around. Amen. But does that change, amen, the deafness of her heart? Amen. That's why David says, amen, we know that David falls with Bathsheba. Amen. David does not confess. Just does not confess. He just does not acknowledge the sin. But David says, amen, God, you got to go deeper than my just action. Amen. David understands there's a root to the problem. The problem, amen, is just not him sleeping with Bathsheba. Amen. There's a deeper problem on top of that problem. David says, create in me a clean heart and renew in me the right spirit. Amen. David understands, God, I'm just not sleeping around just to sleep around. David says, God, I've got the wrong spirit. God, if I can get the right spirit in me, God, I can say no when my body's saying yes. It's the spirit. Amen. Righteousness precedes holiness. Amen. Holiness is a state. Amen. That we get to after we, Lord, we living right. God, I'm striving after you. God, I'm not doing this. God, I'm not being drunk. God, I'm not going to the club. Amen. But how can you refuse sin? Amen. If you don't have the right spirit. Amen. That's why David said, God, I understand the problem. The problem is my heart. The problem is the depths of my soul. Something is wrong with me. It's just not the action. It's something causing the action. Somebody get that later. It is righteousness that precedes holiness. Amen. If I can just get the right spirit. Amen. If I can just get the right heart. Amen. If I can get, and sometimes the reason why we keep falling. Amen. Because you're repenting and you need to repent. Don't get me wrong. I'm not talking crazy. Amen. But you're repenting for the action. Amen. But you're not asking God to give you a new heart. Amen. You say, God, I'm sorry for sleeping around. Amen. But you're not saying, God created me something new. God created me something, God, that will not budge. Created me something, God, God, that's just not like my old nature. God, create something in me, God, that will stand when my body wants to lay down. God, put something down in me. That's why David said, remember this, David says, thy word have I hid down in my heart. So what? That I would not sin against thee. David says, I fell down many times, amen, but I understand, amen, I understand that I've got old and I understand that my heart has to be right. This is what the Hebrew boys understood, amen. They understood, amen, that the issue was just not, amen, just an action thing. So many times, amen, we're worried about the action. And don't get me wrong, the action makes you unholy. Don't get me twisted now. Amen. But to prevent the action, amen, I just can't tell you to stop doing it. Amen. I've got to give you power, amen, to stop doing it. I've got to let you know that it's the right spirit that's in you that will keep you. Amen. That will deposit something in you that will keep you from falling. Amen. It's David that understands it. David says it best. He says, there's one thing God will not despise. Amen. There's one thing, amen, that God will not despise. Amen. I understand I've lived long enough, and I understand, amen, that there's one thing that God will not despise. Amen. It's something about David, these Hebrew boys, that they understood, amen, that in the face of pressure, in the face, amen, of devastation, in the face of what seems to be, amen, defeat and chaos, they are able to still stand. And I'm fascinated because I don't understand, amen, I don't fully understand, amen, why, amen, there's such a stance, amen, when the king approaches them. Amen. Look at the scripture. The Bible says, amen, amen, that they see them not worshiping the image. Bible says that they see them not worshiping the image. They're confronted and they say, King, we want you to know something. Uh-huh. We are not careful to answer you in the matter. They said, King, we want you to know. Now this is another revelation, because this type of faith is different.
All right.
Because they didn't ask God to deliver them.
Come on.
They said, now, King, we know the God that we serve.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah.
They said, King, we know who he is.
Come on.
We know our God has all power.
Come on.
They said, we know our God has all might.
All right.
They said, but King, we want you to know, amen, that even if God does not deliver us this day, he says, King, I want you to know, even if I die today, I would rather die standing on the principles of God than to bow down and worship something that's not my God. They understood this, that guess what, King, we understand your purpose. We're not trying to disrespect you, amen, but we're not careful now. We're not going to negotiate. We're not going to have a discussion. We don't need to have a Bible debate. King, we are not budging. Amen. King, don't you know that our Shema says that there is only one God, amen, and him that we serve. Amen. They understand that there is a power in the separation. He understands, amen, there is something powerful, amen, when you separate yourself from things, amen, from the world. Amen. They understand, amen, that there's something powerful, amen, about separation unto God. They understand, amen, that there's something powerful, amen, that when I can distance myself from the world. They understand, amen, that there's sometimes, amen, amen, that I won't want to live right, but I've got to make myself, amen, and put my flesh under subjection. Amen. I've got to make myself when I don't want to. Amen. 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 You know what deliverance is? Deliverance, amen, amen, is when, amen, you keep telling yourself no when your body wants to say yes. Amen. That's deliverance, amen. Amen. You keep telling yourself no, no, I won't. No, I will not. No, I won't pick up the phone. No, I won't go there. And after a while, God, amen. After a while, amen, you can walk by some things. Amen, amen. And they don't even touch you. Amen. The old church would preach total deliverance. They don't preach that nowadays, like talking about it. Amen. But I remember a time when they would preach total deliverance. I remember a time, amen, amen, that the crackheads would come to church and lay down the crack.